Today, we're visiting the Far East as we explore how a Japanese firm, Tsubame, has turned sci-fi dreams into reality with Archax, a 15-foot-tall human-man robot that can be controlled by a human pilot inside the robot's body. This groundbreaking innovation has stepped out of the screen into the real world nearly two decades after the release of the first Transformers movie, which was Tsubame's inspiration to build Archax. Join us as we unravel the world of Archax's innovation, a fusion of engineering marvel and sci-fi dreams come true. Before we dive in, we would like to ask you to subscribe to our channel for more exciting AI breakthroughs. Unlike past ventures, which remain confined to screens, Archax transcends cinematic boundaries, introducing a tangible giant that defies convention. The giant robot has not made its way into the consumer market yet, and it's unclear if it ever will. Although some believe that Archax would be used more as a prop for the Japanese entertainment industry, Tsubame claims it has several ideas for Archax's applications in the near future. Archax's features depict it as a replica of the Autobots featured in Transformers. The body of the megaton giant machine is made up of iron and aluminum, and the exterior is composed of fiber-reinforced plastic. Archax stands at 15 feet and weighs approximately 3.5 tons. The giant robot stands on four legs as opposed to two for added stability and comes equipped with wheels to ensure smooth movement. There are a total of 36 cameras fitted throughout the exterior of Archax's frame, which convey audiovisual data via three monitors installed inside the cockpit. A key element in Archax's design is ease of access and ease of use. The robot is almost entirely controlled via two joysticks. Tsubame's Archax blurs reality and entertainment, showcasing unprecedented strides in human-man robotics. This marvel stands testament to the remarkable progress in modern engineering. Ryo Yoshida, Tsubame's CEO and the visionary behind Archax, aimed to fulfill sci-fi dreams, letting enthusiasts operate machinery seen on screen. As a fan of such concepts, he aspired for the colossal steel structure to push engineering boundaries. And, of course, the machine that's modeled after the Transformers comes with the ability to transform into a vehicle. Archax boasts two configurations for versatile functionality. In its extended wheelbase stance, the robot stands shorter, reaching speeds of up to 6 miles per hour. Conversely, a compressed wheelbase elevates its stature but caps speed at 1 mile per hour. The seamless transformation between vehicular and robot forms takes a mere 15 seconds. Notably, even in robot form, Archax relies on its wheelbase for support. This extension, influencing the center of gravity, facilitates higher speeds. These adaptable configurations cater to diverse preferences, aligning with the entertainment industry's appetite for innovation. Yet, the question lingers whether Archax's vehicular mode will meet street legal standards. Tsubame reportedly spent over 4 years designing and perfecting their machine. Displayed at the Tokyo Big Sight exhibition alongside other supercars, Tsubame's mega machine outshone with innovation. Capturing the audience's imagination, Archax, guided by a Tsubame team, showcased its prowess by seamlessly transitioning between configurations, captivating the crowd. Akinori Ishii, Tsubame's chief technical officer, revealed the Gundam series as a notable influence on Archax's design, emphasizing its anime-inspired roots. Ishii's belated involvement, sparked by Yoshida's social media teaser, underscores the collaborative nature of this groundbreaking endeavor. The Tokyo exhibit marked a pivotal moment, highlighting Archax's versatility and the convergence of entertainment-inspired design with real-world engineering. Now, the fundamental question lingers: what role does Archax play? As Archax paves its way to becoming a reality, the team is actively engaged in the commercialization process. Despite the buzz surrounding this robot, there are aspects that the team at Archax is fine-tuning before it becomes available to the public. This ensures that, when it finally hits the market, it's optimized for the best user experience. One of the standout features of this mecha robot is its articulating fingers. Picture this: a human seated in the cockpit, effortlessly controlling Archax's movements, extending its fingers to grasp objects up to a 15-kilogram weight limit. This feature adds a practical touch, potentially expanding Archax's applications beyond mere spectacle. The excitement sparked by the announcement of a Transformer-style mega machine like Archax is evident. However, the revelation that only 5 machines in this line will ever be produced, starting with Archax, raises a lot of questions, especially that each machine comes with a hefty price tag of $2.5 million. While this may seem steep, it aligns with the pioneering nature of Archax. The cost is a reflection of the cutting-edge technology and innovation that goes into creating such a unique robot. Now, let's delve into the why. Why create a humanoid robot like Archax in the first place? Tsubame's goal with Archax is to turn science fiction into reality, letting people effortlessly operate robots, bridging the gap between entertainment and real-world accessibility. Expanding on the broader applications, Tsubame envisions Archax as more than an entertainment prop. The company suggests potential roles in disaster management and space navigation. For instance, the robot's articulating fingers, controlled by a human operator, allow precise object manipulation up to a 15-kilogram weight limit. This capability hints at applications in scenarios where human intervention is challenging, such as handling hazardous materials during disasters or conducting delicate operations in space. Although Archax's current focus is on entertainment, its design showcases adaptability and a glimpse into a future where humanoid robots could play pivotal roles in solving real-world challenges. According to Yoshida, one of the several applications of Archax in the range of several humanoid robots that it'd follow would be participating in anime-style game battles with other people who own such robots. This very suggestion from the CEO of the company would be enough to suggest that Archax is meant to be used for entertainment purposes for the uber-rich. He said, "We want to fight using a few units. Not actual combat, but using virtual reality. So in the actual reality using real robots, the fighting is using the virtual reality technology. Like a game," he said, "that is the next step." More so, Ishii, Tsubame's CTO, who'd previously worked with Japanese firm Hitachi as an engineer, claimed that Archax's true use was in space, specifically on the moon. He claimed that there were several large-scale machines already on the face of the Earth, and the logical next step was to bring a large excavation machine onto the surface of the moon. In essence, Archax is not just a glimpse into the future of entertainment, but a testament to how far modern engineering has come. While the road ahead for Tsubame's humanoid machines is long, Archax stands as a symbol of innovation, sparking curiosity about the possibilities that lie ahead in the realm of robotics and technology. Despite marking a milestone in modern engineering, Archax and its successors currently lack the finesse for practical applications. Presently, Archax functions more as an entertainment prop, showcasing Tsubame's technological prowess rather than offering immediate real-world utility. The robot's primary role is as a promotional device within the entertainment industry, emphasizing its Transformer-inspired design. However, Tsubame's visionary leaders, Yoshida and Ishii, foresee broader applications, hinting at a future where advancements in humanoid robotics could extend beyond entertainment to address real-world challenges. While this potential is promising, it's essential to acknowledge the current focus on entertainment and the gradual evolution needed for Archax to fulfill its envisioned versatile roles. What are your thoughts on whether Tsubame's Archax holds potential for real-world applications, or if it's primarily a showcase of the tech firm's creativity? Share your opinions in the comments below, and if you enjoyed this video, give it a thumbs up and subscribe for more AI breakthroughs.